Hey, I'm Craig, and today for the Surfboard Guide, we're doing our initial thoughts on the Chile Surfboards Black Vulture 2. So those that might be familiar, we did a review maybe 2 years ago on the original Chile Surfboards Black Vulture. The thing was absolutely epic. For those familiar, I took it to Sri Lanka on a trip I went on. It was the only board I pretty much surfed the whole time. There wasn't too much it couldn't do. So Chile have just bought out the Black Vulture 2. So chatting with Chile and the boys, the Black Vulture 2 is actually aimed at much smaller and weaker waves. So what they've done is they've flattened out the rocker just a tad. They've widened up the outline a little bit, so there's a bit more volume and width throughout the whole board. And also the Black Vulture, the original, had a semi-flyer that sat here just to give that kind of wide outline a nice little tight pull into a tighter tail, and they've bumped that off. So looking at it, it's still kind of like a little gentle hip, nothing crazy, and it does come into a neat little tail, but they've bumped that off. So a few changes. Also flipping over the Black Vulture too, on the bottom, it has a single concave throughout the board, comes through the board, and then it says it has a really gentle double that comes through the fins and out the tail, nothing too aggressive. Just a really nice bottom that will surf well in pretty small and average waves. So as per our normal initial thoughts clips, I've had a couple of quick surfs on Black Vulture 2. Waves have been pretty average where I am lately, so I haven't been surfing kind of big or great waves. So this board's been pretty good. Had some kind of sideways wind swells and peaky sort of stuff, and I've been grabbing this. It's been good. It's been a fair while since I surfed the original Black Vulture, so I can't remember exactly how it went. I watched the clip, the review again the other day to familiarize myself with it. But it feels, you know, there's some similarities. The waves I've been surfing on this have been really, really weak, but this has felt like it's had some really good power, paddle power. And I think that's due to this kind of, this width in the front of the board. So still a lot of width. It's not overly thick, and it foils out quite nicely, but there is quite a bit of width through the front end of the board. So you've got a bit of foam under your chest, so you're paddling, you've got that kind of surface area, so it's nice and easy to get into waves. And down the line, it's been pretty quick. Like I said, the waves have been pretty weak, but it's felt really nice. The tail and the back end felt really nice and snappy. We're just getting some kind of nor'east wind swell peaks. We could do a couple little hooks and stuff. The board felt really, really good. The guys at Chile were saying to surf it as a 2+1. So I've been riding the MR Twins by FCS, and they felt really good. If you ride Futures, the T1 is pretty much a similar fin, but this has felt really good. That's all I've surfed. I've had a couple of surfs. It's felt pretty good. I'm also going to try out some thrusters in it as well. So maybe like the H4s, the Chloe Andinos, and the AMs, just to get a feel of how it goes with a few different setups. But the boys were saying it was kind of designed with a 2+1 in mind, and that's felt really good. Actually, even with the original Black Vulture that we checked out, I think they were going for a thruster with that, and I ended up riding the T1, so I rode it as a 2+1, and I felt like there was nothing it couldn't do. So I'm gonna chuck some thruster sets in it. If there's something you'd like to see as a thruster set by FCS in the review, you know, comment below or hit us up at the Surfboard Guide, at the Surfboard Guide on Instagram. We can engage about the board and let me know your thoughts and what you'd like to see in the full review. So yeah, hopefully get to check it out in, you know, a wider range of conditions, get in some bigger and better stuff. They're saying it's a board for kind of, you know, waist high to overhead. So hopefully get to check it out in all those conditions. Coming into summer in Australia now, you know, we're gonna get waves in the kind of 2 to 4 foot range, but they're probably gonna be a little bit wind affected. But that's probably when I grab a board like this anyway. So hopefully get some footage together and get the full review out soon. But yeah, if there's any questions you've got about the board, anything you'd like to see in the review, you know, you're thinking of buying one or whatever, yeah, again, comment below or hit us up at the Surfboard Guide on Instagram. Thanks to Chile Surfboards for the Black Vulture 2, and hopefully get some footage together and the full review out shortly. Thanks so much for watching.